trust me, man. I know a way. Before I was downgraded from Vita, I used to work in archive research. I read a book once. It was called...
The Bibble.
The Bibble?
The Bibble.
It talks of the most important thing in the world.
Vardas?
No. No, not Vardas. Bigger than Vardas. Bigger than the process.
Nothing is bigger than the process. The process is all things.
I know. I used to think all that, too.
But there is something in this Bibble called Loeb, which is bigger even than the process.
Loeb?
Loeb. It's all in the Bibble.
What is this Loeb that is in the Bibble?
Well, I'm not too sure yet, Rihanna, but I think it's something like this.
Oh, sorry. No. It is forbidden. That is the old way.
No, Rihanna, no. No.
You're wrong. This is fresh.
Damn it, you're right. Let's get back down again.
Can I help you, my children?
No, thanks. No, we're going back down. Thank you.
You are escaping. You are fugitives from the process. You need have no fear. Your young lungs will soon accustom themselves to our fresh air.
Who are you? Your hair is white. And your skin, why is it lined?
I am Nicholas. What you see, my child, is the effect of old age.
I did not think we would find anyone else in Overworld.
There are few of us, but we are strong. We lead a simple life. We read books. Go.
You read books? I read books. Here, look.
Ah, from the Bible.
No, it is from the Bible, and it talks of loaves.
Nicholas, can you tell us what this loaf is?
Tell us, Nicholas.
You want to know what love is.
Rihanna, we have much to learn in this strange new world.
Chilling excerpt there from Vincent Hambro's Tomorrow, made in 1961 and portraying a society of genetically programmed human beings working for an all-powerful state system referred to in the film as Vardas. But how much of that film was science fiction and how much a prophecy of science fact? Tonight, with the help of Dr. Adrian Cowlacey, a practicing clinician at St. Thomas's Hospital, London, and Max Bellhaven of the Bastard Institute in California, we will be showing you that with the results of experimentation carried out both in this country and in Wales, there is very little room left for science fiction.
Yes, with the help of our audience, we shall tonight be examining the quite extraordinary leaps forward made, the quite remarkable laws discovered in the field of genetic science.
Imagine a society divided into three categories or classes, if you like. An upper category of administrators and rulers, a middle category of professional people, and a lower class of workers and manual laborers. A self-perpetuating system, each kept to their own social place. Sounds like some kind of crazy dream, doesn't it? Or does it?
Much of what you're about to see has never before been seen on television. In particular, we'll be showing you the results of a unique human experiment revealed to the public for the very first time. It's all part of genetics, the science of the future today. Come with us now as we take a look through the crystal cube.
Ideas in the film Tomorrow derived almost exclusively from the work of one man, the mid-Victorian scientist, theoretician, and, some would say, prophet, Harris Edgeley Woad. Woad was born and brought up in a working-class home, which his parents had specially built in the grounds of their Gloucestershire estate. After 4 years of natural history at Cambridge, Woad published his first book, Tim and the Big Red Engine, which earned him enough money to continue his studies in London. He first excited the attention of the scientific community when he delivered a paper to the Royal Institution in the spring of 1876.
My Lord Duke, fellow academicians, Betty. 4 years ago, I embarked upon a course of investigations which was to take me far beyond anything I had dreamed to be possible.
In 1872, Woad had been examining the process of cell division in animal tissues. He was on the point of publishing his conclusions when a curious mischance led him to take a totally different road.
Yes, Mrs. Sparsley, what is it?
Pardon the liberty, sir, but you haven't eaten for days. I don't know as when I've seen cook in such a father as when you sent back her vegetable broth untasted. And she had a leak in it. Special, knowing as you're partial.
It's all right. I'll put it down. I'll have
a little bit. Be careful. It's gone all over the slide.
Sorry, sir.
Well, don't just stand there. Get a cloth or something.
Yes, I'd better hurry, sir. Otherwise, knowing the properties of animal tissue, shouldn't be at all surprised if the hot tea acted as a sort of polarization catalyst on the internal genetic structure, facilitating some sort of chromosomal mutation, and then the old secret of human reproduction would be open to us, sir, wouldn't it? And then where would we be? Lasers, quartz watches.
What was that again, Mrs. Sparsley?